In this question, they're saying there are five special dishes in a collection of 10 dishes. So there are five special dishes. Let's call them S1, S2, S3, S4 and S5, the special. And there are ordinary dishes, which are O1, O2, O3, O4 and O5. So these are the dishes, and now we have to serve these dishes, serve 7 dishes. Out of these 10, we have to pick 7 and serve them in a sequence. So we are looking at permutations, we are not looking at combinations. And they are saying at least three special dishes should be served. So of the 7, you can have 3 special dishes or 4 special dishes or all 5 special dishes. And all special dishes are served consecutively. That is, they are served together. There is no serving of an ordinary dish in the middle of the special dishes sequence. So we consider the three cases, which are case 1. Let's consider the easiest one, which is 5 special and 2 ordinary. Before we look at the permutations, the ordering, let us see how many ways we can pick these dishes in the first place without any sequencing. So there's only one way to pick the 5 special dishes, because there are only 5 special dishes. And here you can do 5C2, which is 5 factorial by 3 factorial into 2 factorial, which gives us 10. So in 10 ways, we pick 2 ordinary dishes, and in one way, we pick 5 special dishes. Now we have our 7 with us. However, these 5 put together, they make one block, 5 special. So other than that, we have 2 ordinaries. So in effect, it's like we are dealing with 3 entities. Which is basically 2 ordinary. And the one sequence of 5 special dishes. So now these 3 entities can be permuted in 3 factorial ways. And within them, our special sequence has 5 factorial permutations within itself. So each of our 3 entity permutations gets 5 factorial permutations. And then the picking of these 2 ordinary dishes happens in 10 ways. So we further multiply this by 10, which is basically 5C2. And this should be our answer for the case 1. So let us make sure we understand these terms. This 3 factorial is to account for permutations of the 3 entities. And these 5 factorials are the permutations of the special sequence. So for every permutation of these 3 entities, you get 5 factorial permutations of the special sequence. And for every such permutation of 3 entities, we have to pick, this is the number of ways to pick 2 ordinary dishes. So for every such permutation, we have 5C2 options of picking the ordinary dishes. So all put together, this is the answer we get for case 1, which gives us 3 factorial is 6 into 5 factorial is 120 into 5C2 is 10. So we get 7200 ways. This is for case 1, where you have 5 special and 2 ordinary. Now let's look at case 2. Which is 4 special. So these 4 we get in a sequence and three ordinary. These we get as independent entities. So now we have, as by our previous logic, we have four entities. These four special together is one entity, and then each of the ordinaries is one entity. So since you have four entities, we will have four factorial permutations. So every permutation of our four entities also should account for the four factorial permutations within the sequence. And now we also have to account for how many ways we can pick four special items from five. So we have 5C4. And how many ways we are picking three ordinary items from five, which will give us 5C3. So this is going to give us 24 into 24 into 5 into 10. So that is 28,800 ways for case 2, which is 4 special and 3 ordinary. That leaves us with case 3, which is 3 special and 4 ordinary. So these three special, they come together like this as a special sequence, whereas the four ordinary gives us four independent entities. So this time we have five entities leading to five factorial permutations of these entities. And again, each of these permutations will have to consider the permutations within the special sequence, therefore that is 3 factorial. And now we look at how many ways we can pick these 3 from 5, so that is 5C3. And again, picking these ordinary ones from 5, that is 5C4. So this will give us 120 into 6 into 10 into 5. Which is equal to 36,000 ways. So all put together, we are getting 36,000 for case 3 plus 28,800 for case 2 plus 7,200 for case 1. So that gives us 72,000 ways in all.